Hi everyone, Amanda Hartman, speech pathologist here, and maybe if you've been watching some of my videos, you might have noticed me telling the time and the day. If I click more, I've made some buttons that say
the time is 11:09 a.m.
and
today is Thursday, the 25th of June, 2020.
Right now, and the day today as I'm making this video. This feature is called a macro. Now, to me, a macro, if I want to tell you the definition, is kind of like a single instruction that expands automatically. So a macro, to me, it's just magic. So it's a magical way that we can add a button that's constantly updated and it's always going to be there. You can even add
battery power is 87%.
Your battery power. So it might make sense if you wanted to add some time and date buttons to your Proloquo2Go, maybe you could add them in your time folder. So I'm going to navigate to the time folder now, and I'm going to enter into edit mode by clicking the pencil on the bottom toolbar. When I'm in edit mode, I'm going to add a button. So click on add a button, and I'm going to start typing. The time is, and you can see I already have an appropriate symbol chosen for me. And what I'm going to do to find the macros, I have to go all the way along the line where I've typed over to this little button on the side here. It's kind of like a blue speech bubble with a plus in it. So I'm going to click that, and here are my expressive powers, the different things I can do. I can add sounds, expressions, but also there's a tab called macros. So when I want to add the time, I just have to scroll down to find the time. And you can see the time has got that kind of double crocodile bracket on it, and it's going to be constantly updated. So the time is 11:11 a.m. And we can do the same with the date. So plus, type in some text. Today is, check that I have the symbol that I want to use. Go all the way along to my expressive power button, open the macro tab, and add in the format of the date that I want. Now the text is a little bit big on this, so I'm just going to decrease it so we can see all of the text. And now I have a time and a date button. So let's test it, see if it works.
Today is Thursday,
yes,
the 25th of June, 2020.
Fantastic. Hey, look, how easy is that to add time and date macros or buttons to your Proloquo2Go? And you know what that means, guys? Now we can spend far less time on our calendar work every morning. We don't need that. We can do it in like 1 second and get on with much more important learning. So I hope that that's a strategy that's helped you today about how you add time and date macros in Proloquo2Go. Thanks for watching. Bye.